चैन सिमर सिमर बैग आपके निरीक्षण के लिए हाजिर है।
Thank you. prayer, Vande Mataram.
Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Sujalam Sufalam Malayaj Sheetalam Shasya Shyamalam Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhajyotsna Pulakitayamini Pullakusumita Dhumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram Vande Mataram
Your Excellency, the Chancellor of Geetham University, Padma Shri Professor Koner Ramakrishna Rao, esteemed Chief Guest, Padma Shri Dr. T. Ramaswamy, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, Honorable President, and the towering strength of Geetham, Dr. MVVS Murthy, distinguished recipients of honorary degrees, Padma Vibhushan, Prithvi Raj Singh Obrai, Kalanidhi, Dr. N. Krishnamurthy, eminent neurosurgeon, Dr. S. Palaparameshwar Rao, respected members of the governing body and board of management, Professor D. Harinarayana, Pro Vice Chancellor, Professor M. Potaraju, Registrar, Heads of Institutions and Departments, Teaching Faculty, Staff, My Dear Students, Distinguished Guests, Press and Electronic Media, Ladies and Gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the third convocation of this great university. I deem it a privilege to welcome His Excellency Padma Shri Professor Koner Ramakrishna Rao, the Chancellor of the University. We are indeed fortunate to have with us a very distinguished chief guest, Padma Shri Dr. T. Ramaswamy, a world-acclaimed scientist and dynamic administrator. I am extremely delighted to welcome you, sir. It is an honor and great privilege to welcome Dr. MVVS Murthy, Honorable President, Geetham, the third convocation also marks a successful completion of 5 years of Geetham as a university of global standards. I am extremely happy to inform you that since the second convocation held on 20th August last year, the university has been steadily marching ahead on all fronts. Today, Gandhi Institute of Technology and Management, popularly known as Geetham, has emerged as one of the premier universities in India. I am happy to inform you that today we have 3 campuses at Visakhapatnam, Hyderabad, and Bangalore with 11 institutes, 9 faculties, 46 academic departments and 7 research centers. At present, the university is offering 109 UG, PG and doctoral programs in diverse disciplines. There are over 11,500 regular students, 750 full-time teaching faculty and 450 research scholars hailing from almost all the states of the country. During the last academic year, the university has accomplished significant achievements. The university has been accredited by NAC with A grade, UGC has granted 12B status to the university. The university has been selected for providing funds under TechEp 2 program. Under FIST program, DST was kind enough to grant financial assistance to strengthen mechanical engineering department. In addition to several other significant developments took place since the last convocation, I would like to highlight some of them. During the academic year 2012-13, we have introduced 5-year integrated BA LLB honors, BBA LLB honors, and 3-year LLB, which are being run on residential programs. The university conducted online admission tests at 18 centers and online counseling at 5 centers across the country. The response for the admissions to various programs for the academic year 2012-13 has been overwhelming. During the last year, scholarships and fellowships are given from the university funds to 5% of the total UG and PG students pursuing various programs. The university adheres to UGC regulations in all matters, particularly in recruitment of teaching faculty. In the last year, we have recruited about 160 well-qualified and experienced teaching faculty through duly constituted selection committees with senior professors from central universities, IITs, and IIMs as members. We have strengthened the infrastructure by constructing elegantly engineered buildings, that is Industrial Engineering Bhavan, School of Law, Ravindra Sagar Sadan, to meet the needs of academic departments and hostels. Further construction of ladies hostel and faculty quarters and a separate building for Institute of Gandhian Studies are in progress. During the year, the Knowledge Resource Center has been further enriched with books and journals. Today it has a rich collection of 1.45 lakh books, 22.44 lakh e-books, over 450 national and international journals, and over 600 e-journals. In the last year, the university has undertaken several major research projects funded by various funding agencies such as DST, DBT, DRDO, CSIR, etc. I am very happy to inform that Dr. C.H. Murali Mohan, Department of Biotechnology, has developed a new biopest product named as Geetam Trishul with the financial assistance from NABARD. The university has undertaken bulk production of Geetam Trishul with the financial assistance from NABARD and supplying it to the farmers free of cost. Our faculty have published over 750 research papers in refereed journals and 30 books during the last academic year. The university established a Center for Social Entrepreneurship Development with an objective to encourage social entrepreneurship as a sustainable alternative to employment. It is a unique feature of the university that it encourages students' participation in innovative research projects. A team of students of Geetam Institute of Technology participated in Lunabotic mining competition at NASA. Mr. Vikas Singh, a student of industrial engineering, has designed another innovative device called AeroRest Arm model, which is registered for a patent. Ms. C. SSV, a student of CSC, received the Best Student Award from TCS. And NCC students of the university won the Sahara India Award. The university organized several national and international seminars and conferences in the thrust areas with the financial assistance from various funding agencies. The Center for Gandhian Studies has been doing credible work in spreading Gandhian thought and philosophy. During the last year, the center launched a half-yearly publication, Journal of Gandhian Studies, the university continues to give Best Teacher and Best Supporting Staff awards, which are presented on the Foundation Day every year. Geetham Foundation Annual Award, which was instituted with the gracious corpus of Rs. 3 crores donated by Dr. MVS Murthy, Honorable President of Geetham, was presented to Padma Vibhushan Professor M.S. Swaminathan for the year 2012. We express our gratitude to Padma Vibhushan Akkineni Nageswara Rao for donating Rs. 10 lakhs as corpus for institution of Srimati Annapurna and Nageswara Rao Akkineni Merit Scholarship to MSc girl students with rural background from the academic year 2012 and 13. The Hyderabad campus, which was started in 2009-10 in the industrial hub of the capital, has been successfully offering BTech, MTech, and MBA programs. The infrastructure at Hyderabad campus has been substantially strengthened. In the era of globalization, Bangalore is emerging as a hub of higher education in the country. I am very happy and proud to inform that the university has started its second off-campus at Bangalore with state-of-the-art infrastructure facilities for classrooms, laboratories, and other supporting services. Initially, the center will offer BTech and MBA programs, and steps will be initiated to start science and pharmacy programs in a phased manner. We will focus on international student admissions, taking climate and other locational advantages at Bangalore. The Center for Distance Learning has been successfully offering 13 UG, PG, and diploma programs. This year, an executive MBA program was started under distance mode. Geetham high standards are well recognized by multinational corporations in IT, banking, and other fields across the country, drawing them to conduct campus interviews on a large scale. During 2011-12, a total of 2,000 students were placed through campus interviews, which is a record in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The highest package offered was Rs. 16 lakhs, while the average package was about Rs. 4 lakhs per annum. It is a matter of great pride and also satisfaction that the alumni of the university are occupying high positions in government and industry in India and abroad. The university has been giving top priority to establish and strengthen a network of alumni, associating them in the academic activities. The university organized alumni reunion meetings in December 2011, wherein a good number of alumni across the world, along with their families, actively participated. During the last year, many distinguished personalities visited this campus. Prominent among them are Sri V. Kishore Chandra Dev, Union Cabinet Minister for Tribal Welfare and Panchayati Raj, Dr. D. Purandareswari, Minister for State for HRD, Professor Veda Prakash, Chairman UGC, Dr. D. Subbarao, Governor Reserve Bank of India, Professor M.S. Swaminathan, Chairman M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation. The brief highlights of this university since the second convocation point out that we are marching ahead with full vigor and enthusiasm. I wholeheartedly express my sincere thanks to Padma Shri Professor Koner Ramakrishna Rao Garu, Chancellor of the University, for his support in all our endeavors. I express our sincere thanks once again to Padma Shri Dr. T. Ramaswamy, the chief guest whose august presence illuminated this solemn occasion. I would like to thank the Honorable President, Dr. MVS Murthy, for his continued support and guidance. I wholeheartedly congratulate Padma Vibhushan, Prithviraj Singh Obrai, Dr. Bala Parameshwar Rao, and Dr. Nedanur Krishnamurti, who will be receiving their honorary degrees shortly. My hearty congratulations to all the graduates who are here to receive their degrees, winners of medals and best research awards. I wish to convey our thanks to MHRD, UGC, DST and other funding agencies for their cooperation and support. I am particularly thankful to media friends and their continued support and encouragement. On this solemn occasion, let us resolve to dedicate ourselves for the success of this esteemed university by delivering long-term value to the stakeholders, meet societal obligations, and contribute for nation building. Let us strive to always uphold the great traditions of Gautam University. Thank you, and thank you very much.
Let Dr. Thirumalachari Ramaswamy be now presented.
Mr. Chancellor, I deem it a great honor and privilege to present before you an accomplished scientist, a distinguished academician, and an administrator par excellence, Dr. Thirumalachari Ramaswamy, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, whose valuable and pioneering contributions to the field of science and technology have made India proud. Born in 1948 in Sri Viluputtur in Virudunagar district of Tamil Nadu, Dr. T. Ramaswamy pursued his graduate and postgraduate studies in leather technology at the University of Madras, Chennai. Dr. Ramaswamy's insatiable thirst for knowledge and deep passion for science and technology led him to the University of Leeds, United Kingdom, where he obtained his PhD in chemistry in 1976. Continuing his pursuit to explore new frontiers of knowledge, he moved over to the United States for his postdoctoral research at the Ames Laboratory, Iowa State University during 1978-80 and at Wayne State University, Detroit during 1981-83. For his excellence in research endeavors, he was awarded the coveted position of visiting fellow at the University of Newcastle upon Tyne during 1983-84. These opportunities at various institutes of higher learning helped Dr. Ramaswamy to broaden his perceptions and vision on the latest developments and emerging fields in science and technology, which he has successfully put to use in various positions occupied by him later in India. Dr. Ramaswamy's eventful professional career began as a scientist at Central Leather Research Institute, CLRI, Chennai, in 1984. With his commitment, enthusiasm, perseverance, and vision, he soon rose to the position of director of CLRI Chennai within a short span of 12 years. Dr. Ramaswamy made substantial contributions to the resurgence of CLRI. Under his visionary leadership, CLRI earned a global leadership status in leather technology research. Dr. Ramaswamy's seminal contribution during this period is the launching of several innovative initiatives. The Leather Technology Mission, with 170 projects in 17 states of India, with new development models in place, has created a special place for the country in the global arena, having adopted cleaner technology options backed by original publications and several patents under intellectual property rights. An outcome of this pioneering technology improvement initiative is the saving of more than 2,50,000 jobs in leather industry, substantially contributing to the national economy, the tune of over 6,000 crores of rupees. Dr. Ramaswamy's focused research on mechanistic chemistry, industrial applications of chromium salts, and dew ecology solutions to industrial environmental problems has given him special recognition in the field of chemical sciences. Some of his major research contributions include demonstration of anomalous reactivity of chromium stabilization of unused oxidization states of chromium, mechanistic insights into the chromium-induced apoptosis of human lymphocytes, understanding host-guest interactions in biomolecular systems, and development of technologies for improved tanning salts and systems in leather industry that paved way for significant developments in chromium chemistry and leather technology. His foresight for sustainable development through science has culminated in the generation of boundless opportunities for academic fraternity entrepreneurs, and industry, ultimately impacting the society at large. Dr. Ramaswamy's flair for juxtaposing the cause of science with resources at hand and public policy support, complemented by innovation, commitment, and patriotism, facilitated his launching of highly innovative futuristic programs marked with great social relevance, such as Technology Mission on Water and Energy, Innovation in Science Pursuit for Inspired Research, popularly known as INSPIRE, Promotion of University Research and Scientific Excellence, popularly known as PERS, Winning, Augmentation, and Innovation of Water, popularly known as WAR. PERS program is a proactive initiative of DST taken up under Dr. Ramaswamy's leadership that proved to be a big boon for research activities in the universities. It facilitated value addition to R&D in performing universities. Similarly, INSPIRE program, aimed at inculcating scientific temperament in the young minds right from the school level, was conceptualized, designed, and implemented by Dr. Ramaswamy. INSPIRE supports at least 2 promising students from every school in the country to pursue education and career in science with attractive scholarship scheme right up to the doctoral level. This well-conceived program, with clarity of purpose and perception, provided unprecedented opportunities not only to the promising future citizens of India, but also ensuring a solid and sustainable scientific base for the future of this country. His war on water was at the instance of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, having reposed confidence in his scientific and administrative capabilities. He was entrusted with the responsibility of suggesting research-based technological solutions to address various challenges in water management in different parts of the country, especially in providing safe, potable drinking water to the masses. He discharged this responsibility with aplomb. Dr. Ramaswamy has to his credit over 220 research publications in highly peer-reviewed journals, 8 chapters in books, and numerous popular articles. More importantly, his zeal for innovation and application has earned him more than 37 patents, out of which 12 were already put to commercial application. Several of these technologies are indigenous in nature. His rich research experience and achievements demonstrate a perfect balance between basic and applied research. In recognition of his contributions to leather research and introduction of environmental friendly technologies, he was invited by the American Leather Chemists Association to deliver Arthur Wilson Memorial Lecture. Dr. Ramaswamy was the recipient of numerous prestigious awards. To mention a few, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award for Chemical Sciences, 1993, Special Award of Honor by Indian Leather Technologies Association, Waswick Prize for Chemical Sciences, 1997, Environmental Technologies Award, 2004, Om Prakash Award, 2001, Silver Medal of the Chemical Research Society of India, Professor G.S. Ladda Endowment Lecture Award, IACT Darshan Endowment Lecture Award, Alpha Orator Award, Elizabeth Matta Endowment Oration, Material Research Society of India Medal 2001, Platinum Jubilee Award of the Indian Chemical Society 2001, Acharya P.C. Ray Memorial Award, Kimito Award for Excellence in Chemistry and Life Sciences, and so on. The coveted Silver Award of the country, Padma Shri, was conferred on him by the Government of India in 2001 for his invaluable services to the nation. His election as a fellow of respected science academies, such as National Academy of Sciences, Indian National Academy of Engineering, and the Academy of Sciences for the Developing World, along with other coveted awards, is a testimony to his contributions to science and technology at national and international levels. The concepts of green chemistry, the way forward for a sustainable world, and science in shaping the future of India reflect his commitment to bring the fruits of science and technology for the benefit of mankind. Dr. Ramaswamy's value system, work ethic, and concern for the masses are reflected from his often quoted statements. I quote, "Practice is more valuable than preaching." Professional ethics in research and its cultural dimensions go together. Unquote. He always presents himself as, quote, "a student of science raised in the rich cultural heritage of India," unquote. Dr. Ramaswamy is a rare blend of innovation, competence, social concern, and national spirit with overflowing kindness and warmth at heart. Geetham University feels proud to honor this illustrious son of India, Dr. Ramaswamy, an eminent scientist of international repute and an able administrator, for his outstanding achievements and services to the nation. Mr. Chancellor, with a deep sense of appreciation for his distinguished and outstanding contributions to science and technology, may I request you to be so kind as to felicitate Dr. Tirumalacharya Ramaswamy on this momentous occasion.
Chief Guest Address.
Let Dr. Tirumalacharya Ramaswamy address the convocation.
Very good afternoon. After that stunning introduction, I thought you were introducing some other Ramaswamy. And I don't think, I'm very grateful to the person presented me. I wish I deserved some of what was said. Honorable Chancellor of Geetham, Honorable President, the Vice Chancellor, the Pro Vice Chancellor, Sri Oberoi, Sri Kalanithi Krishnamurti, Dr. Rao, Registrar, respected members of the governing body, members of the board of management, recipients of these honorary degrees today, heads of institutions, heads of the departments, faculty, students, parents, representatives of the media, friends, ladies and gentlemen, and graduates receiving the degrees on this occasion. Let me first of all express my warmest greetings to all of you assembled here today, and specially congratulate the new graduates. Having participated in more than 160 convocations so far, I am not easily given to accept responsibilities for delivering addresses on these occasions. One of the prime motivating factors for consenting to deliver this address is the name of the university itself, Gandhi. The university has been named after a man who spoke universal truth. Those graduating from this university are reminded constantly of the man who experimented with truth and lived by the ideals he stood by. On this day, I have chosen the topic on inspirational leadership for this address as a mark of respect for the man under whose name this institution has been founded more than 32 years ago. I had an opportunity to browse through the vision of 2020 of this Geetham University. Let me congratulate the visionaries envisioned such a dream. Vision is considered as a dream minus reality. The dream of 2020 of Geetham is to emerge as a global leader among all educational institutions. Universities and educational institutions are expected to create future leaders and promote leadership. In other words, some of you who are graduating today are expected to gain for this university the leadership that Geetham is aiming at. Whenever a university is measured for its value and performance, it is the societal value added by the graduates and the alumni that should be evaluated, not just the performance. All the ranking in global systems is made on the basis of success of an institution in the marketplace of education. When education becomes a product transacted between educational entities and the educated for exchange for money, the pristine quality of education as a process would undergo the undesirable changes. Under such circumstances, the leadership gives way to the management priorities. In modern times, the metrics of measurement seem to create on the evaluation management rather than societal values. Since the goals of Geetham center around leadership, I thought I could share with you today some of my recent thoughts on sustainable leadership models that universities like Geetham could examine. The title on inspirational leadership is motivated by the vision of 2020 of Geetham and the inspiration for the world, Gandhi as a symbol of universal value. It has become general practice in the world to couple roles of leaders and leaderships very strongly. While leaders as a group form human subjects, leadership should be ideally considered as an organizational capacity. While leaders as human beings bring value to their role for finite periods during their lifespan, performing organizations have relied on leadership capacity of the institutions well beyond the lifetimes of individuals. Leaders focus on what is good for people for all time to come, while managers focus on what would please the people of the tenure of the leadership. There is some universality in leadership traits that one must focus upon. Let us take the example of the life of Mahatma Gandhi. Did Godse's bullet bring an end to Gandhi so far? My answer is no. Gandhi is not the past, he still remains the future, because he spoke the universal and timeless truth. He gave the principle for inspirational leadership. Let us take the example of Nalanda University. Nalanda is the name of an ancient university in Bihar. It was a Buddhist center of learning from 427 CE to 1197. It has been called one of the first great universities in recorded history and maintained leadership for the longest periods in human history. The curriculum of Nalanda University contained virtually the entire range of world knowledge then available. This was a case of global leadership. Nalanda actually means insatiable in giving. What made Nalanda University remain at the apex of higher education in the world for more than 1,000 years? I would dare say that it was because of inspirational leadership. When excellence of institutions is built around the charisma of an individual, the alternations of high and low in the performance cannot be avoided. If excellence is built into the institutions and organizational culture through inspiration of every member of the organization, sustaining excellence becomes feasible. Sustaining leadership over long periods of time calls for more than charisma of individuals and leadership models centered around individual human beings. While attaining global leadership is one type of challenge, retaining excellence in educational enterprises over long periods is yet another challenge. If Geetham were to target the global leadership in 2020, the lessons from history of work within the university and attain excellence are to be gained. To me, inspiration is an elevated state of mind. When thoughts are elevated, the mind is inspired. It attains a rare level of beauty and passion for excellence. It is able to extract extraordinary values for the human effort and genius. An inspired mind is uninhibited. It knows no limitations and constraints. It reaches a stage where the painful realities of mundane and dreary human habits vanish. In some sense, it's a stage of trance. Creativity prevails over everything moving and stationary when the mind is truly inspired. Inspired minds cross barriers of human boundaries and search for contributions that transcend beyond the lapse of time. The minds of Buddha, Mahavir, Gandhi, Tagore, Raman, Jain, Tata, Mother Teresa, and some of our leaders were all inspired. They spoke of such truth that gained universality of relevance in terms of both space and time. They managed to inspire millions of minds which did not share the history of time with their own lifetimes and yet exert influence over centuries. Let's take the example of Gandhi. He was not just a role model. He was much more. He did not rely on charisma. He was not a leader who selected his followers. He received the following of people who had not even seen him. People like me, who had not even born when he lived, but his lessons to the world received following the people were born well after his time. I call him an inspirational leader. Such leaders continue to receive the following by people for many generations and many nationalities. The foundation of this very institution in 1980 seemed to have been inspired by the ideals of Gandhi. In my opinion, the establishment of Geetham gives a proof of a following of that great man. Of course, when an institution is named after an icon like Gandhi, there's a responsibility on all of you to follow for honoring his ideals. He believed in universal access to education for all. His lessons became more important than his physical life, ending in January 1948. His leadership was built on the principle of inspirational leadership. Inspirational leadership is all about creating a flame that continues to burn eternally. It should lead to the creation of an organizational culture which sustains the inspiration of minds even a long number of generations and long periods of time. When universities in Europe have remained excellence over centuries, it is appropriate to ask as to what makes them different. The University of Bologna has maintained excellence for 750 years. They are not even driven by individuals and leaders with finite lifetime, but by inspirational leadership capacity of those organizations. Such leaderships are intergenerational, they sustain. Many institutions in modern India go through cycles of rise and fall because of some of the leadership models employed. Therefore, in the present context, there appears to be some merit in examining the lives of five immortal lives of this country. Ladies and gentlemen, I propose to flag the lessons from five great lives that have conquered death and gained immortality through the timeless values and lessons that remain relevant and universal. They are Buddha, J.N. Tata, Tagore, Gandhi, and Sir C.V. Raman. Their lives speak the truth, bear the messages written in the language of the universe, and they remain as inspirators transcending beyond time and lapse of human memory. All the five lives have three things in common that they stood for. They stood for the good of people for all time to come, centered on the truth, and cared for universal goodness. Grammar of the five lives changed the grammar of tense in language. They spoke of freedom, they spoke of knowledge, they spoke of morals, they spoke of ethics, they spoke of ethos. Ladies and gentlemen, I quote from Sir C.V. Raman as an inspirator. A purposeful life needs an axis or hinge to which it is firmly fixed and yet around which it can freely revolve. As I see it, this axis or hinge has been, in my own case, strangely enough, not the love of science, not even the love of nature, but a certain abstract idealism or belief in the value of human spirit and the virtue of human endeavor and achievement. The nearest point to which I can trace this source of idealism in my recollection of reading Edwin Arnold's great book, The Light of Asia. I remember being powerfully moved by the story of Siddhartha's great renunciation of his search for truth and his final enlightenment. When the Nobel was announced, I saw it as a personal triumph, as an achievement for me and my collaborators, recognition for a very remarkable discovery, for reaching the goal I had pursued for 7 years. But when I sat in the crowded hall and I saw the sea of Western faces surrounding me, and I, the only Indian in my turban and close coat, it dawned on me that I was really representing my people and my country. I felt truly humbled when I received the prize from King Gustav. It was a moment of great emotion, but I could restrain myself. Then I turned around and saw the British Union Jack under which I had been sitting. And it was then that I realized that my poor country, India, did not even have a flag of her own. And it was this that triggered my complete breakdown. You can see that the life of C.V. Raman received its inspiration from the life of Buddha, who lived several centuries ahead and impacted the life of another great life, Sir C.V. Raman, through inspirational leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, to me, J.N. Tata remains as a messiah for self-reliance with freedom from independence and fire for internationalism. Let us examine the major projects in which J.N. Tata invested his effort and wealth. He formed Tata and Sons in partnership with Sir Dharamji Tata and R.D. Tata in 1887, set up J.N. Tata Endowment Scheme in 1892, founded the Taj Mahal Hotel in Bombay in 1898. The history is, he tried to go to a 5-star hotel and they refused. So he decided to build a 5-star hotel and allowed the Europeans to stay. and that's how Taj Mahal Hotel came in. Yet by the Swami Vivekananda, he laid the foundation for science and education in India by establishing the Institute of Science in 1899, and he declared IISc as his third son and gave away 1/3 of his wealth. From 1880 till his death in 1904, his entire being had concentrated solely on three missions of his life, namely setting up an iron and steel company, generating hydroelectric power, and creating a world-class educational institution that would enrich Indian minds in the field of sciences. He sourced knowledge from wherever it was available and believed in his conviction on self-reliance and industrial India, and built at the core of his business concern for the welfare of people and not just a profit to investor. To his sons, he left a message to carry forward. It read thus, quote, "Be sure to lay roads, wide roads, plant shady trees of quick growing variety. Be sure that there's plenty of space for lawns, reserves areas for football, hockey, parks, ensure places for worship, Hindu temples, Mohammedan mosques, Christian churches." And these were his plans for Jamshedpur. In the life of Sri J.N. Tata, there remains a lesson for inspirational leadership for generations to come in establishing institutions for the good for people, like the Gita itself. Ladies and gentlemen, Tagore was not just a poet who won the Nobel Prize for Literature. He was a philosopher. He was a thinker who thought ahead of time and defined the world what freedom of thought meant and what education should constitute. These are his lessons for generations to come. To quote from Tagore, quote, "Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into the fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the words come out from the depth of truth, where the tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert and sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into the ever-widening thought and action, into the heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake." To quote from his Nobel lecture, "You know the traditions of our country are never to accept any material fee from the students to return for teaching, because we consider in India that who has the knowledge has the responsibility imparted to students." Ladies and gentlemen, to present Gandhi as an inspirator for generations of leaders is an easy task. What made Gandhi's model of leadership in freedom struggle succeed is a quantum of following it received and level of inspiration it created. He did not select his followers. Millions of followers selected him as a leader because he was inspiring and remains inspiring even today. He is part of a recent history, but he enshrined in his philosophy and practices the lessons of Buddha and Mahavir. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the life of Buddha as an everlasting inspiration for generations that followed and likely to follow from now on is like narrating the importance of sun for lives on earth. And I recognize several of your horses are named after Buddha, and that's a great thought. He stated all universal truth and narrated experience that would remain relevant for all human life. His was a leadership that has spanned centuries and remained afresh even today. This is an example of global leadership for all time to come. All the five lives emanated from Indian civilization. They focused on freedom. Buddha focused on freedom from desires. Gandhi focused on freedom from oppression. Tata on freedom from dependence. Tagore on freedom from fear, and Raman freedom from colonialism. Inspirational leadership emanating from all the five lives was built on universal truth and insatiable act of giving. They transcended beyond time and speak timeless values. Leadership is an aspect of influencing the thought and actions of people in a positive manner. Inspirational leadership demands the creation of an ambience and a system that inspires people and self-propels into an organizational capacity. Five lives that opened the windows on the world have left a level of inspiration that has self-propelled over centuries in both time and geographical space and remain a lesson for billions of people. Inspirational leaders focus on future and big dreams. They desire big impacts, and their goals aim at universal goodness, and their personality are magnetic and promote self-enrollment of followers, and the strength emanate from conviction and confidence. Such leaders inspire ordinary people to deliver extraordinary results through empowerment of thought. They transform people and organizations through self-propelling and sustainable work ethics and culture. Ladies and gentlemen, those of you preparing for lives ahead from Gita have borrowed his name from this institution. It is a challenge and an opportunity at the same time. It's a challenge to live up to the ideals of Gandhi, but it's also an opportunity to follow his ideals. The vision of 2020 of Gita spoke of leadership among educational centers of the world. Metrics of measurement of Rasindh leadership could evolve a larger number of tangible parameters. The leadership of the kind of Gandhi rests in their intangibility too. The values of a leader are even more important than the charisma. Universal values of education are built on developing good citizens with humane approach and social consciousness. I am not certain as to whether the global ranking takes into account the good citizenry values of the alumni or not. I sincerely wish the alumni of Gita University become the best citizens of the world. There are two models for excelling in life. One model is to surpass others and other institutions in relative scales. The other, followed by Gandhi, was to surpass oneself perpetually and ceaselessly. In the process, he reached the stage of the Minerva top of all human beings of his time and generations to follow. I would like to leave a thought among the graduates of Gita to try and follow the model of Gandhi by surpassing yourselves perpetually and deliver values to your life, values of your life to other people. Let me hope that Gita would reach the global leadership that it seeks through the goodness you spread in the world, let alone the greatness that the most people speak for. There is greater, deeper message for all of you in the lessons on the inspirational leadership from the five lives. Long live the inspirators who spread the message of goodness in an imperfect world order. I really sincerely wish every one of you become the greatest citizen of the world. Jai Hind.
Now, let us all give once again a very standing ovation. A brilliant, inspirational speech.
Admission to the honorary degrees of Doctor of Science and Doctor of Letters.
This convocation of the Gita University has been called to confer the honorary degree of Doctor of Science on Sunkara Balaparameswara Rao and honorary degree of Doctor of Letters on Sri Prithviraj Singh Oberoi and Sri Nenduri Krishnamurti, and to confer the degrees upon them.
Admission of Sri Prithviraj Singh Oberoi to the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
That Sri Prithviraj Singh Oberoi be now presented.
Ms. Chancellor, I consider it an honor and a privilege to present before you Mr. Prithviraj Singh Oberoi, a legendary hotelier and a visionary and an embodiment of the spirit of achievement and excellence in business leadership, who will be receiving the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters at today's convocation. This honor to Mr. P.R.S. Oberoi is in recognition of his lifetime contribution to the hospitality and tourism industry and his pioneering leadership in making Oberoi Group a global brand by taking the concept of luxury to a new paradigm. Popularly known as Vicky, Mr. P.R.S. Oberoi is the son of the founder of Oberoi Group, late Rai Bahadur M.S. Oberoi. Mr. P.R.S. Oberoi is the chairman and chief executive officer of EIH Limited, the flagship company of the Oberoi Group, and also the chairman of Oberoi Hotels Private Limited, the major shareholder of EIH Limited. Mr. Oberoi and his education in India, the United Kingdom, and Switzerland. Mr. Oberoi is credited with placing Oberoi Hotels on the International Luxury Travelers Map with the opening of several new luxury hotels in important locations in India and abroad, redefining architectural and design standards in luxury hospitality in consonance with the local environment. It is Mr. O'Brien's firm belief that people are the most valuable asset of any organization. He lays stress on attention to detail and people management as the two ingredients that define hospitality. Mr. O'Brien is committed to the conservation of the environment and is a member of the World Wide Fund for Nature. With the objective of catering to the future manpower needs of the hospitality industry, Mr. O'Brien established the O'Brien Center of Learning and Development at New Delhi in 1966. Today, this institution is considered amongst the best in Asia. Above all, Mr. O'Brien is aware of the need to constantly promote quality in every segment of the hospitality industry. With his immense knowledge, experience, and managerial skills, Mr. O'Brien is responsible for creating a generation of hoteliers and contributed to the hospitality industry that made India one of the best in hotel business in the world. Mr. O'Brien, a paragon of efficiency and reliability, has received many accolades for his exceptional leadership, vision, and pioneering effort. He was bestowed with the prestigious Grand Officer of the Alaloy Wisdom Award personally by His Majesty King Mohammed VI of Morocco in recognition of his contribution to tourism and to Indo-Moroccan relations. The Department of Tourism, Government of India, in recognition of his contribution to the tourism sector, conferred a special award on Mr. O'Brien in 2004, commending him, "Due to your entrepreneurial skills and visionary leadership, the O'Brien Group has risen to a global brand renowned for its high standards of service and excellence." Mr. O'Brien is honored with lifetime achievement awards by several national and international organizations. The prominent awards among them are Lifetime Achievement Award by 6th International Hotels Investment Forum at Berlin, March 2003. Lifetime Achievement Award by Hotel Investment Conference Asia Pacific at Hong Kong in October 2005. Lifetime Achievement Award by the CNBC TV 2007. Lifetime Achievement Award by Business World and National School of Design in 2007. Lifetime Achievement Award by 4th Hotel Investment Conference South Asia, April 2008. Lifetime Achievement Award at the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award in November 2008. Lifetime Achievement Award at the First Economic Times Thai Travels Award in 2009. In 2008, Mr. O'Brien was conferred with India's second highest civilian award, Padma Vibhushan. In recognition of his exceptional service to the country, Mr. O'Brien received the Outstanding Business Leader Award from the Associated Chambers of Commerce and Industry and Society of Indian Law Firms in September 2008. This award was presented in recognition of Mr. O'Brien's leadership in establishing high standards of excellence in various hotels and resorts of the O'Brien Group. Mr. O'Brien was conferred the Businessman of the Year Award in 2008 by Business India magazine for building a world-class premium hospitality brand. Mr. Prithviraj Singh O'Brien is the recipient of the First Hall of Fame Award at the Hotel Investment Forum India in February 2009 for his outstanding business practices, leadership, and achievement. Mr. O'Brien was presented with the 2010 Corporate Hotelier of the World Awards by Hotels magazine in November 2010, which referred to him as the founder, father of modern luxury hospitality in India, and credited him with developing the company into one of the world's most prestigious luxury hotel groups. Mr. O'Brien is currently the director and member of Investors Grievances Committee at EIH Limited, President and Chairman of Investors Grievances Committee at EIH Associated Hotels Limited, Chairman of the Board, Mercury Travels Limited, Chairman of the Board, Mumtaz Hotels Limited, Chairman and Managing Director, Indus Hotel Corporation Limited, and the Chairman of the O'Brien Group. Mr. O'Brien is happily married to Mrs. Goody and is blessed with two sons. Geetham University feels proud to honor the founder father of modern luxury hospitality in India, Mr. P.R.S. O'Brien, who exemplifies outstanding business practices, leadership, and achievement both professionally and personally. Mrs. Chancellor, with a deep sense of appreciation for his outstanding contribution to hospitality industry and tourism sector, I request you to be so kind as to confer the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters on Mr. Prithvi Raj Singh Oberoi. Thank you.
In the name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Geetham University, I confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters in this university. And a token thereof, you have been presented with this diploma. This diploma, I authorize you to wear the gown and hood ordained as the insignia of your degree. Congratulations.
Admission of Sri Nedunuri Krishnamurthy to the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
That Sri Nedunuri Krishnamurthy be now presented.
Mr. Chancellor, I consider it an honor and privilege to present before you Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy, the recipient of the honorary degree of Doctors of Letters at today's convocation. This honor to the living legend in Carnatic music, Sangeeta Chakravarti, Sri Kala Parapurna Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy, is in recognition of his lifetime contribution for promoting the cause of Carnatic music, both as a practitioner and as a guru, working relentlessly for his propagation and preservation, blending together the art and science of music. Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy was born on 10th October 1927 at Kothapalli, Pittapuram Taluk, Andhra Pradesh, to late Sri Ramamurthy Panthulu and Srimati Vijayalakshmi. He imbibed musical heredity from his mother and maternal uncle and had the blessings of Sri Kaluri Venugopal Rao and Sri Mantina Appala Narasimham, who identified and nurtured his musical talents in his childhood. This music prodigy joined the Maharaja's Music College at Vijayanagaram in the year 1940, where he had his initial training in violin and vocal music from late Sri Dwaram Narasingha Rao Naidu, who has laid a solid foundation for Dr. Nedunuri's career as a vocalist. The year 1949 is a landmark in his long and eventful career, when he became the disciple of great master Sangeeta Kalanidhi Padma Bhushan Dr. Sripada Pinakapani, whose guidance helped him delve deep into the enchanting ocean of music. Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy had a long and eventful association with several prestigious government music and dance colleges at Vijayawada, Secunderabad, Vijayanagaram and Tirupati as a member of the faculty and as the principal. He has been instrumental in introducing Ragarasam and Swarakalpana as a part of the syllabus. He was associated with Sri Venkateswara, Nagarjuna and Andhra University as the Dean of the Faculty of Fine Arts, Chairman of Board of Studies and Visiting Professor in Music. With the noble aim of preserving and popularizing the traditional value of Carnatic music for posterity Dr. Nedunuri established a trust, Nada Sudha Tarangani. Under the aegis of the trust, three volumes of Annamaya Pada Saurabham, consisting of 108 Annamacharya compositions, set to mellifluous tunes by Nedunuri, with notations, were published. Further, 54 Ramadasu Kirtanalu and 25 Kaivaram songs with notation have been published by trust and the audio CDs released. In recognition of his valuable services for popularizing Annamacharya compositions, Dr. Nedunuri has been appointed as Astana Vidwan of Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam. Dr. Nedunuri's tunes are acclaimed as fountains of Bhakti Rasa. His unquenching thirst for music made him bring to light some of Tyagaraja's compositions and were set to the enchanting tunes. Nedunuri's tunes to the Narayana Tirtha Tarangams are cascades of traditional Carnatic flavor. His tunes are so alluring that Bharat Ratna Sangeeta Kalanidhi late Srimati M.S. Subbalakshmi sang a few tunes of his. Nedunuri's tunes coruscate with the visual spectacles by eminent Kuchipudi and Bharatanatyam teachers like Vempati Chinnasathyam, Dr. Shobha Naidu, and many others. Dr. Nedunuri is the only Vidwan from Andhra Pradesh who has performed uninterruptedly for over 5 decades at the prestigious Madras Music Academy. A renowned platform for many a great artist to exhibit his talents. He is also associated with All India Radio for the last several decades as a front-rank artist and is a member of the Carnatic Music Audition Board. With a well-defined and expressive execution of Bhava, Dr. Nedunuri's performances are always a masterly redemption, and music aficionados float along the limpid waves of musical ecstasy. His amazing powers and scholarship won him immeasurable prizes, honors, and titles. To quote a few, Sangeeta Chodamani, 1976, Sangeeta Kalasagra, 1980, Nada Sudha Nidhi, 1981, Ganak Academy Award, 1986, Saptagiri Sangeeta Vidwamani, 1987, Sangeeta Samrat, 2001, National Eminence Award, 2010, Sangeeta Kalasikamani, 2011, Tagore Academy Ratna, 2012, and a host of other awards. He is also the recipient of Honorary Doctorate from Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University in 2010. Dr. Nedunuri also received many laurels in the United States of America and many other countries. Dr. Nedunuri's tunes are an amalgamation of traditional rigor and elegance. The moving melody of his tunes transport the listeners to the heaven of peace and tranquility. Dr. Nedunuri's offers his music as a vehicle for everyone to share the joy of Nadopasana. His greatness as a vocalist manifests itself when we look at the famous names of the instrumentalists that have accompanied his concerts, such as Lalgudi Jayaraman, Umayalpuram Sivaraman, Palakkad Raghu, Palakkad Mani, etc. His continuing performance at music concerts, valuable publications, and his large and renowned Sishya Parampara speak volumes of his unflinching commitment and devotion for the cause of music. Nada Yogi Nedunuri is a music connoisseur's delight, tonal quality, and continuity. Inimitable styles are his assets. His redemption of Bhava-laden music in the Manodharma tradition is unique. Dr. Nedunuri has been described as an embodiment of quintessential qualities of South Indian classical music: aesthetic grace, excellent style, technical elegance, rhythmic accuracy, and captivating melody. A guru's greatness is measured in the terms of the caliber of his shishyas. Seeping through the boundaries of Carnatic music, Nedunuri's mission is to catch the young and nurture them with a taste of classical music and tradition. Many a renowned contemporary artist in classical Carnatic music had their training from Dr. Nedunuri. Notable among them are Kalaparpurna Sri Domada Chittiyabbai, Srimati Koka Satyavarti, Srimati K. Saraswati Vidyarthi, Sri Garimala Balakrishna Prasad, Srimati Shobha Raju, Malladi Brothers, Sri Ram Prasad and Ravi Kumar, Srimati Sharda Subramaniam and Srimati V. Lalita Chandrasekhar. Geetham University feels proud to honor this eminent artist who at 85 continues to display remarkable enthusiasm and finesse in pursuing his chosen vocation, enthralling the connoisseurs of Carnatic music. May he serve the world of music with his melodious voice in his inimitable style for many more years to come. Mr. Chancellor, with a deep sense of appreciation for his distinguished and outstanding contributions for promoting the cause of Carnatic music, I request you to be so kind as to confer the honorary degree of Doctors of Letters on Dr. Nedunuri Krishnamurthy. Thank you.
In the name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Geetham University, I confer upon you the degree, the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters in this university. And in token thereof, you have been presented with this diploma, and I authorize you to wear the gown and hood ordained as the insignia of your degree.
Admission of Dr. Sunkara Bala Parameswara Rao to the honorary degree of Doctor of Science.
Let Dr. Sunkara Bala Parameswara Rao be now presented.
Mr. Chancellor, I consider it an honor and privilege to present before you a committed and dedicated doctor of international repute with a rare blend of academic acumen administrative caliber, Dr. Sunkara Bal Parameswara Rao, who is the recipient of honorary degree of Doctor of Science at today's convocation. This honor to Dr. Rao is in recognition of his outstanding lifetime contributions to the field of medicine in general and neurosurgery in particular. Dr. Rao was born on 12th February 1928 to Sri Sunkara Kankam and Sri Seshamma Bhimavaram, West Godavari District, Andhra Pradesh. He had his early education in Bhimavaram, Machilipatnam, and Madras. Dr. Rao is a distinguished alumnus of Andhra Medical College, Vishakhapatnam, where from he graduated with distinction in medicine and surgery in 1950, winning several medals and prizes. He was the recipient of Tata Cherry Gold Medal in Pathology, Dr. Ramurthy Prize in Bacteriology, AMC Silver Jubilee Prize for the best outstanding student, among others. He obtained his PG degree in surgery in 1954, again with distinction, and was the recipient of Ebden Gold Medal in surgery. Dr. Rao joined active government service in 1953. His first posting was at the King George Hospital, Vishakhapatnam, where he has continued served for 2 decades in different capacities. The years 1955, 56, 59 and 60 are milestone in Dr. Rao's professional career, where he had first exposure and training in neurosurgery at the Government Hospital, Chennai, under renowned Dr. Ramamurthy and advanced training in UK. Thus began his long eventful saga in neurosurgery. Equipped with specialized training in neurosurgery, ingenious Dr. Rao established Department of Neurosurgery in Andhra Medical College, Vishakhapatnam, 1956 and is remembered forever as a father of neurosurgery in Andhra Pradesh. He nurtured the department with devotion and dynamism, vision, bold, quick decisions, accompanied with exemplary work ethic are the hallmarks of his leadership in running the department. Many renowned neurosurgeons of the country had their education and training here. Dr. Rao's illustrious and eventful career is a great inspiration to many a doctor. He served as a professor of neurosurgery, Usmania Medical College, neurosurgeon, Usmania General Hospital, professor of neurosurgery, Nizam Medical Orthopedic Hospital, principal medical college, dean, faculty of medicine, Usmania University. He retired from government service in the year 1983. Later, he served as a professor of emeritus in neurosurgery, Usmania Medical College, honorary neurosurgeon, Nizam Institute of Medical Sciences, and SVIMS Tirupati. It is his discipline, immaculate efficiency that helped him to secure a position of eminence. Research was Dr. Rao's forte and passion. The large number of his scholarly publications in national, international journals, and his lucid orations and presentation in professional gathering indicate a range of exposure and interest in several facets of neuroscience. He has published more than 81 scientific papers, contributed a chapter on spinal tumor, a textbook on neurosurgery, and delivered many prestigious orations. Scores of PG students had the benefit of his guidance and supervision in presenting their dissertations in various clinical aspects of neurosurgery. He was a member on more than 40 expert committee and selection boards. Dr. Rao is associated with several professional bodies in the field of medicine and neurology, such as Indian Academy of Medical Sciences, Neuro Society of India, Neurospinal Surgeons Association of India, AP Neuroscientists Association, as a member, fellow, and president. His splendid academic competence, diligence, devotion to his profession earned Dr. Rao many accolades and awards. He received the prestigious Dr. B.C. Roy National Award 1989, Distinguished Scientist Award from AP Academy of Science 1999, Lifetime Achievement Award from Andhra Medical College 2005, Lifetime Achievement Award from Indian Stroke Association Chennai 2006, Lifetime Achievement Award from Neurospinal Surgeons Association of India 2011, Ugadi Puraskaram from Government of Andhra Pradesh 2012. He was conferred honorary doctorate by NTR University of Health Science Vijayawada in 2008. Dr. Rao belongs to an era of medical professionals who primarily relied on their innate abilities of knowledge, intuition, and experience in the diagnosis and treatment of medical problems with missionary zeal. He continues to serve the profession with dedication, sharing his knowledge and experience with generations of students as a professor of emeritus at several medical institutions. Even today, he conducts free clinics for the needy from all walks of life in different parts of Hyderabad city. He made himself dear to the patient with humane approach, philanthropic attitude, adhering to the tenets of Hippocrates' oath he has administered several decades ago. Dr. Rao is happily married and is blessed with a son and a daughter. Geetham University feels proud to honor this eminent medical professional and father of neurosurgery in Andhra Pradesh. Mr. Chancellor, with a deep sense of appreciation for his distinguished contributions to the medical profession in general and neurosurgery in particular, I request you to be so kind as to confer the honorary degree of Doctor of Science and on Dr. Sunkara Balaparameshwar Rao. Thank you.
In the name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Geetham University, I confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Science, this university. And in token thereof, you have been presented with this diploma, and I authorize you to wear the gown and hood ordained as the insignia of your degree.
presentation of the Best Researcher Awards.
Let the recipients of the Best Research Award be now presented.
Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you the candidates for the award of Best Researcher. Professor K. Arunalakshmi, Department of Biotechnology, GIT. Dr. K. Arunalakshmi is presently Professor of Biotechnology in Geetham Institute of Technology. After obtaining PhD from Andhra University, she received postdoctoral training in United Kingdom, Australia, and Israel. During her distinguished career, she won many awards such as Best Paper Presentation Award twice at the All India Botanical Conference, Dr. S.C. Deekshit Prize for Best Paper published by women authors in the Journal of Indian Botanical Society. She has published several papers and completed many projects funded by various agencies in the areas of plant-microbe interactions and tissue culture. With her strong belief in praxis between laboratory and land, Professor Arunalakshmi is actively engaged in participatory research with farmers of the north coastal Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Arunalakshmi is currently working with a team from King George Hospital and Harvard Medical School, investigating the causes of widely prevalent kidney disease at Uddanam in Andhra Pradesh. Geetham University is pleased to honor Dr. K. Arunalakshmi, distinguished scientist and accomplished academician, with the Best Researcher Award 2012 at the third convocation held on 15 September 2012. Dr. M. Sarat Chandra Babu, Professor of Chemistry, GIS. Dr. M. Sarat Chandra Babu is currently working as Professor of Chemistry, Geetham Institute of Science. He obtained MSc and PhD from Andhra University. A versatile scholar, Dr. Sarat Chandra was the recipient of DFG postdoctoral fellowship to work on bio and nanomaterials and NSF postdoctoral research fellowship, where he worked in the area of phosphate-based micro and nanoporous materials. He worked as a scientist at the University of Karlsruhe, Germany, and National Tsinghua University, Taiwan. He published extensively on nanomaterials with industrial applications. An innovative scientist, Dr. Sarat Chandra, is currently working on two prestigious projects, MOF materials for hydrogen storage and luminescent microporous materials supported by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Government of India and CSIR New Delhi. Geetham University is pleased to honor Professor M. Sarat Chandra Babu, an accomplished researcher and academician with the Best Researcher Award 2012 at the third convocation held on 15 September 2012. Dr. R. Venkateshwaralu, Professor in Statistics and Operations Research, GSIB. Dr. R. Venkateshwaralu is presently Professor of Statistics and Operations Research in Geetham School of International Business. A postgraduate in applied mathematics, he obtained PhD from Andhra University in 1991 and continued with CSIR postdoctoral research fellowship for 3 years in Andhra University. Dr. Venkateshwaralu is a committed researcher working in highly diversified areas such as theory of relativity, inventory models, and econometrics. He worked on a UGC major research project on higher dimensional cosmological models in alternative theories of gravitation. He published more than 50 research articles in the areas of theory of relativity and inventory models. He is an editorial member of ISR in Mathematical Physics and Geetham Review of International Business. Geetham University is pleased to honor Professor R. Venkateshwaralu with the Best Researcher Award 2012 at the third convocation held on 15 September 2012. Pledge.
Do you sincerely promise and declare that if admitted to the degrees and diplomas for which you are individually and severally candidates and for which you have been recommended, you will, in your daily life and conversation, conduct yourselves as become members of this great university? Do you promise that to the utmost of your opportunity and ability, you will support and promote the cause of sound learning and to set an example of high principles and conduct? Do you promise that you will, as far as in your rights, uphold and advance social progress and well-being of your fellow men? Do you promise that you will faithfully and carefully fulfill the duties of the professions that you are trained for, and that you will, on all occasions, maintain their purity and reputation, and that you will never deviate from the straight path of their honorable exercise by making your knowledge subservient to unworthy ends? Candidates for the degrees and diplomas we now present.
resolve.
Admission to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering, Master and Bachelor of Technology in Engineering.
Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace of the Board of Management just passed, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for admission to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Technology, and Bachelor of Technology in Gautama University. Doctor of Philosophy, Mr. Cheruku Dharmaraj, PhD in Electronics and Communication Engineering. Master of Technology, M.Tech program. L. Sudharani Abburi, first ranker in M.Tech Computer Science and Technology in the year 2012. Dandu Durga Anusha, Dandu Durga Anusha, first ranker, M.Tech Digital Systems and Signal Processing. Mr. Muhammad Abdul Mehboob Khan, first ranker, M.Tech Electronics and Instrumentation. J.R. Ravikiran Kopelli, M.Tech Machine Design, first ranker. Lakinan Dinesh, first ranker, M.Tech Power Systems and Automation. V. Alekhya, first ranker in M.Tech Software Engineering. Jitendra Babu N., first ranker in M.Tech Structural Engineering and Natural Disaster Management. Hanumantu Satya Suresh, first ranker in M.Tech VLSA Design. Nahas Shokat Ali, first ranker in M.Tech Industrial Engineering and Management. Noka Ratna Latakumari, first ranker in M.Tech Computer Science and Technology Evening Program. H.S. Lakshmi, first ranker in VLSA Design Evening Program, M.Tech. Now Bachelor of Technology, B.Tech programs. E. Pratima, she won Presidential Gold Medal for overall first ranker from all branches of B.Tech and first ranker in CSE. M. Sunil. He won Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Gold Medal for Best Outgoing Mechanical Engineering Graduate and First Ranker in BTEC Mechanical Engineering. V.V. Lakshmi Narasimha Raju, First Ranker in BTEC Biotechnology. R. Sindhura, First Ranker in BTEC Civil Engineering. Priyanka Naidu, First Ranker in BTEC Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Parjur Kavya, First Ranker in BTEC Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering. Yes, Lakshmi Harika, First Ranker in BTEC Information Technology. A. Maurya, First Ranker in BTEC Mechanical Manufacturing and Management Engineering.
Let the candidates for the degrees and diplomas be now presented.
Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace of the Board of Management just passed, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for admission to the degrees of Master of Business Administration, Master of Human Resource Management, Master of Science in Applied Psychology, Bachelor of Business Management, Bachelor of Business Administration Honours, Bachelor of Business Administration, and Postgraduate Diploma in Risk and Insurance Management in the Geetham University. The candidates are as follows. The President Gold Medal for overall First Ranker in Management Studies in Geetham Institute of Management and the First Ranker in Master of Human Resource Management goes to B. Divya Kumar. President Gold Medal, first ranker in Master of Human Business Administration from Geetham Institute of Management goes to Sujita Ogirala. President Gold Medal for First Ranker in Master of Business Administration from Hyderabad Business School goes to Akula Sinduja. President's Gold Medal for First Ranker in Bachelor of Business Management from Geetham Institute of Management, B. Sai Subhanjani. The first rank in Bachelor of Business Administration, Nalamalli Priyanka. First rank in PG Diploma in Risk and Insurance Management, Mr. A. Roy.
On behalf of the Board of Management of Githam University, I admit you to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Technology, and Bachelor of Technology in Engineering in this university. And in token thereof, you have been presented with these diplomas, and I authorize you to wear a gown and hood ordained as insignia of your degrees.
Admission to the degrees of Master of Business Administration, International Business.
Ms. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace of the Board of Management just passed, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for admission to the degrees of Master of Business Administration in International Business. This year, 2012, President Gold Medal for overall performance in international business, as well as Githam Teachers Gold Medal, first ranker in international business, go to Mr. Varun Kumar Vanama.
In the name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Githam University, I admit you to the degrees of MBA, International Business, of this university. And in token thereof, you have been presented with these diplomas, and I authorize you to wear the gown and hood ordained as insignia of your degrees.
Admission to the degrees of Master of Philosophy in Science, Master of Science, Master of Computer Applications, Bachelor of Computer Applications, and Bachelor of Environmental Management.
Mr. Chancellor, permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace of the Board of Management just passed, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for admission to the degrees of Master of Philosophy in Science, Master of Science, Master of Computer Applications, Bachelor of Computer Applications, and Bachelor of Environmental Management in Githam University. Master of Philosophy in Chemistry, Shravana Yashmin. MPhil in Chemistry, Srinivasa Naidu Allam Setti. MPhil in Applied Mathematics, Nalleru Channa Keshavulu. MPhil in Biochemistry, Kamala Golla. the top rankers, President Gold Medal for overall first ranker in all branches of MSc and first ranker in MSc Bioinformatics. President Gold Medal for overall first ranker in all branches of MSc and first ranker in MSc Bioinformatics, Chintakayala Pravalika. MSc Analytical Chemistry first ranker Kalpana Nilapu. MSc Biochemistry MV Lakshmi Chandana. MSc Biotechnology Jagarapu Uma Tulasi. MSc Environmental Science Shaq Ramija. MSc Organic Chemistry Chetikam Vijay Saumya. MSc Microbiology T. Panindra Kumar. MSc Physics Deva Sucharita. MSc Food Science and Technology Danda Anusha. Master of Computer Applications Debashish Shahu. Bachelor of Computer Applications M. Geeta. Bachelor of Environmental Management Baliwada Harish Kumar.
Name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Geetham University, I admit you to the degrees of Master of Philosophy in Science, Master of Science, Master of Computer Applications, Bachelor of Computer Applications, and Bachelor of Environmental Management in this university. And in token thereof, you have been presented with these diplomas, and I authorize you to wear the gown and hood ordained as insignia of your degrees.
Admission to the degrees of Master of Pharmacy and Bachelor of Pharmacy.
Mr. Chancellor, please permit me to present to you, in accordance with the grace of the Board of Management just passed, the candidates whose names are herewith submitted for admission to the degrees of Master of Pharmacy and Bachelor of Pharmacy in the Geetham University. Master of Pharmacy M.Pharm in Pharmaceutical Analysis and Quality Assurance, first ranker P.V. Suryalakshmi. M.Pharm Pharmaceutical Chemistry, first ranker B. Sahitya Lakshmi. Bachelor of Pharmacy, President's Gold Medal for first ranker in B. Pharm, R. Reshma Sri Lakshmi.
In the name and on behalf of the Board of Management of Githam University, I admit you to, and on behalf of the Board of Management of Githam University, I admit these candidates in absentia to their respective degrees and diplomas in the university, and in token thereof, permit the registrar to present them their diplomas and authorize them to wear the gown and hood ordained as the insignia of their degrees.
Signing the record of degrees and diplomas by the Chancellor. Vote of thanks.
I move that the thanks of the convocation be tendered to Honorable Dr. Tirumalachari Ramaswamy for the address.
I second the motion.
Dissolution of the convocation.
I now dissolve the convocation.
National anthem. Retreat.